you know, Source magazine or whatever, give your damn ass an award and you don't even take the time to show up. Damn it, we'll give it to the second person placing that showed up to the damn event. How about that? Back in 3 minutes.
Hey, what's up, sports fans? You're looking for a different type of sports talk show, something you haven't heard before? You gotta check out the BS3 Sports Show every other Saturday on 2 Live Stews Radio, 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern. Sports talk at its finest. Always have great guests playing some good hip hop. You don't want to miss it. Make sure to tune in to the BS3 Sports Show every other Saturday at 1 p.m. Central Time, 2 p.m. Eastern.
Kitchen and I'm on the money mission. Nobody can stop me. No. Just grab your camcorder, press record, and go on and watch me. And you can skate on my ice just like you playing hockey. And in the booth, I beat the beat up. Call me Rocky. Yeah,
call me Rocky. Hey, welcome back to the show. The number to the show is 404-822-5467. You can also email me at Doug@thedougstewartshow.com. This is one of my favorite tracks of all time. That man said, I got a condo around my neck, girl. I'm cashing out. I got a warped sense of humor, man. A lot of shit people don't even pay attention to, man. Really, really tickles me, as my mother used to say. Man, say he got a condo around his neck. He cashing out. Hey, welcome back to the Doug Stewart Show on this Man Talk Monday.
Got a condo around my neck, girl, I'm cashing out. Got a condo around my wrist, girl, I'm cashing out.
Yeah, welcome back to the show, man. A lot went down this past weekend in college football as well. The number to the show is 404-822-5467. We brought to you by DougieDeals.com. Don't look now, man, but Miami back to life, back to reality. Yep. They go on the road, man. Pitt is like the giant killer. Remember now, Pitt beat Clemson last year as well for their only loss of the season. And so Pitt actually beats the Miami Hurricanes. The Hurricanes' first loss of the year, 24-14. And Malik Rozier, just a real off this past weekend as well. Only 15 for 34, 187 yards. He had two touchdown passes, but couldn't make some plays when they needed plays to be made. So we'll get back to the college football scores in a second. But let me grab a call. Hey, caller, thanks for calling the Doug Stewart Show. What's your name? Where you calling from? What you want to talk about? Hello? All right, so we don't have a call. So Miami, man, tough loss, one loss. Everybody, there's no team in that top five. The only undefeated team we got left right now as far as the big boys from the Power Five conferences is Wisconsin. But Miami goes down their first loss in the year. They're 10-1, so the conversation now moves toward this Final Four, or the four in the college football playoff rankings. We'll talk more about that in a second. Also, this past weekend, the Auburn Tigers, man, got it done against Alabama. Yep. That's right. Got it done against Alabama this weekend, 26-14. Very impressive performance by Auburn, man. They just look like the better football team. Now, Alabama's on the road, and you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, Iron Bowl, in-state rivalry, and all this, that, and the other. But Auburn looked clearly like the better team. Jalen Hurts kind of struggled a little bit this past weekend. Jalen Hurts, 13 for 23, 177 yards and one touchdown pass. Stidham for Auburn, 21 for 28, 237 yards. And defensively, man, Jared Stidham passed for 237 and ran for a fourth quarter touchdown. And number six, Auburn, beat top-ranked Alabama 26-14 Saturday with a berth in the Southern Conference, Southeastern Conference title game on the line. All right, so Auburn. Now, with a 10-2 record, beats Alabama. They now play against Georgia in the SEC championship game. You remember just a couple of weeks ago, they put them hands on Georgia. Yeah, they put them hands on Georgia. So, you know, we'll see. Georgia got to make adjustments. And clearly they're not going to go in with the same game plan in the SEC championship game that they had when they took on Auburn a couple of weeks ago and got manhandled. So, big win for Auburn, man. Ball award to Auburn. Ball award to Pitt. Got to give it up. Yeah. Clemson handles their business in the Palmetto State Battle Classic, whatever you want to call it. Kelly Bryant threw two touchdown passes to Hunter Renfrow, and number four Clemson kept on track for a third straight trip to the college football playoff with a 34-10 victory over rival South Carolina. Ball award to them Tigers. Hold them Tigers. Right. Wow. Clemson, man, they'll probably be number one in the playoff rankings that come out tomorrow. Oklahoma handled their business against West Virginia at home against West Virginia, 59-31. Baker Mayfield, 14 for 17, 281 yards, three touchdown passes. And also, one last score, Minnesota. Minnesota beats Wisconsin, or loses to Wisconsin, 31-shit. Damn, sorry, sports governor of Minnesota, Vince Wright. Damn. I said it last week, man. I would hate to be a fan of Minnesota. Like, they've been bad ever since I was living. 31-shit at home. Sorry, Vince. So one of the listeners to the show, good friend of the show, actually hosts his own podcast as well, Vince Wright, the sports governor of Minnesota. Big Minnesota Golden Gopher fan, and they can't get right. Bless their heart. Bless their heart. Still gonna got a couple more games to get into, and then we're going to take a look at the rankings on how I think the rankings are going to come out. J.C. Clyde, Snow Bunny Hunter, makes a very good point in the chat room. It's about to be a lot of pissed off folks next Sunday when Bama makes the playoffs. Yeah, there's going to be a lot. I agree with you wholeheartedly. Bama takes an L to Auburn, but they only have one loss. Auburn has two losses. They take an L. They've been the number one team throughout the year. There's going to be a couple of teams in the top four with one loss. The committee, I've listened to some of these cats on TV this morning on the radio. It feels like, and based on what the committee has done over the last couple of weeks, it feels like that somebody about to get screwed. And that somebody is probably going to be Wisconsin. Now let me say this. I don't necessarily know that Wisconsin's going to get screwed either, because they're probably going to lose in the Big Ten championship game. All right. So there's going to be a lot of hurt feelings. You're right, Jay Clyde, Snow Bunny Hunter, because it feels like, you got to remember, it's not all about the record. That's a big part of it. It's not all about the record. It's partly the schedule, how tough a schedule that you had. And at the end of the day, this is what y'all keep forgetting. When I made this point a couple of weeks ago about Wisconsin and how it feels like Wisconsin's about to get the screwdriver, I made this point. At the end of the day, the committee is tasked with putting who they believe in their heart of hearts are the four toughest teams in college football. Not the four teams with the best record. Not the four teams necessarily with the best record from the biggest conferences, the five power conferences. If they feel like Alabama and Wisconsin played on a neutral field, if they feel like Alabama would win that game, they are going to put Alabama in these playoffs. This is what I said a couple of weeks ago when you're listening to the Doug Stewart Show, and a lot of y'all got mad at me. A lot of y'all got mad at me. Just remember that. At the end of the day, they got a bailout. Their bailout is, Wisconsin is undefeated, but we feel like Alabama would kick their ass on a neutral field. So we're putting Alabama in this thing. And I'm not mad at them. You know, when all things are considered equal or whatever, when all things are considered equal, I totally get it. You want the four best teams on the field. You do. And, you know, if you feel like that Alabama's a better team than Wisconsin, so let it be. So let it be. From Loosneck Side, hey, Wisconsin, make sure they kiss you before they, well, you know the rest. Yeah. And you know what? It may not happen. Wisconsin may make it. But here's the thing about that. They don't want happening what happened last year when Washington had this undefeated record and came into the playoffs and got manhandled. They don't want that. Like, everybody could see it. Stevie Wonder could see that Washington wasn't, you know, going to vie for a national championship, but they had the record. They're from the Power 5 conference, and they put them in the Final Four, and they got mollywopped, okay? And you could kind of see the same traits in Wisconsin based on the other teams that you could put in that top four. So, I mean, it's not looking good. We'll see. A lot of football yet to be played. I think Georgia's going to have a stake on the Final Four as well, you know, but they still got to play in the SEC Championship. We'll finish talking about all of that, and I'll tell you what I think the committee is going to say about the Final Four tomorrow when we get back from the break. All right? A quick 3-minute break, and we'll be back. Don't go away. The Doug Stewart Show.
Pick up your microphones. Pick up your microphones. Yo, how many mics do we rip on the deli? Say many. How many mics do we rip on the deli? Mini money. Say many.
I get mad frustrated when I rhyme. Thinking of all the kids that try to do this for all the wrong reasons. Seasons change, mad things rearrange, but they like the love doctor's range.